Slippery Elm Bark. I'm going to show you how I use this for my baby's food. Slippery Elm is really good. It's very gentle on the digestive system for, anybody with any type of intestinal disorders. It's a nutritive herb. I stink at saying words. But very nutritious to the body, especially for babies. I add this to my baby's first foods, which I'm showing you right here. Here I cooked up squash. See, it's still steaming. I just cooked squash till it was really, really mushy. See if you can tell the consistency with the fork. It just goes right in. So you can tell I boiled it in water. It's about 20-25 minutes. So you get it like where the fork just goes right in. And then with a little bit of the cooking water in there at the bottom, you can see the cooking water. And then I'm just going to blend this up in my Vitamix. And then I'm going to add a little bit of Slippery Elm. She likes that consistency, actually. And it helps get it down. Since this is a new food for her, she hasn't had squash yet, this will help the digestion even easier. So let's blend this up. If you don't have a Vitamix, you've got to get one. These things are awesome. I'm in Germany, so I had to use a transformer. You want one of these, else you're going to have squash all over your kitchen. Okay, so we're going to blend this really, really, really fine. She doesn't really have any teeth. So if you know Vitamix, you just turn it on first and then work it all the way up, and then we're going to supercharge it. So check this out. And that should do it. And like I said, it was really soft to begin with. So let's look at this. Oh, yeah. So that is perfect. That's just how I want it. See, just like that. Now, to add Slippery Elm, what we're going to do is... Oh, hi, Kippy. What's up? Making Mia's food. Now you can do this in the pan. I do this with other food that she eats, some grains, some rice that we have, or the quinoa I make. You can do this right in the pan. Right now I'm just going to do this in a bowl. It helps if you have a fork to, you know, mix with. So I'll show you what I'm going to do. So here's her food. It's really hot. But the Slippery Elm, as you'll see, is... I have the powder form. Okay. As you can see, I get mine from Mountain Rose Herbs. Talk to Colm. Okay. This is my own personal stash, so I just use my hands. My hands are clean. But you can get like a little teaspoon. And if you see, I'm going to put about that much. You really don't need a whole lot. You want to immediately just mix this in. Just mix it in. Mix, mix, mix. And it's going to look like... almost kind of turn into like a jelly type substance. Almost. When I mix this into, in her grains, it comes out more like, yeah, I hate to say it, but it comes out looking like snot, actually. You can use this for colicky babies. This is very safe, very, very good to use. So you see the consistency change, so it's really slippery in a way. Makes it really digestible for her. She's had no problems, no tummy upsets with any of the new foods I've given her. I've always put a little Slippery Elm in there. And she really likes the consistency, actually. And then as a final touch, even though she's still nursing, because she is on, my kitchen. Starting solids, I do add in the Shackley Baby multi-mineral and vitamin supplement. Happy, can you say hi?
Hi.
Awesome. And so I just sprinkle in, I eyeball everything, about a teaspoon or so. So just to give her extra nutrients. You know, it is the what people call the cold and flu season, but we keep taking our vitamins and doing our herbal teas and stuff. All right, that's all mixed in. So she has her Slippery Elm for easy digestion and extra nutrients in there. And then she has her homemade organic squash, of course. If you can, just feed your baby organic foods to eliminate, you know, the toxic exposure. And then her multivitamin, multimineral. You can visit my website to see where to get this. It's great for babies and toddlers. You have, there's 23 vitamins and minerals in here. Good stuff. None of the bad stuff. It's awesome. And my baby's ready to eat. So let's see how well she likes this. Say hi, Mia. She just woke up. Okay, so here's her food, the Slippery Elm, the squash, and the vitamins. And not too hot. Let's see how she likes it. Is that yum yum?
This time I won't.
Very soothing. Just make sure it's just not too hot. It should cool off a little bit. And Mia is just about a year old. She turns one in a couple weeks. But she only has two bottom teeth, so she doesn't eat a whole lot of solids. And it goes down real easy. They rarely choke. Or she not rarely, she doesn't choke. One thing you can also do, if your baby, hi Eli.
Hi. She's gonna turn one on Christmas.
That's right.
And in a few days.
Wait, I don't turn two.
You're gonna turn five.
Five? And we didn't get a Christmas tree yet. We will and get one before Christmas.
Alright, she likes it. It's the winner.
On Christmas, I'll be fine.
Now, sometimes, if your baby is prone to illness, ear infections of some sort, it could be because they have an imbalance in their intestines with a good microflora. If that's the case, this is something you can give your child, is the little probiotics. Sometimes if you just do yogurt, they get destroyed in the stomach and they don't really make it into the gut where it's needed in the intestines. So these probiotics, if you see, they're really tiny. You see how tiny that is? Really, really tiny. Some of these can even fit inside of a little straw. So what you can do is put in her food like that. Of course, we can all use some good microflora in our intestines and just cover it up. It's in there. And this is the very first time she's tried it. Okay. My camera died, but as you actually, it went right down. She swallowed it, no problem. So as long as your baby is just a good swallow, they don't really mess around with what's in their mouth. They won't even notice it's there. And it's really smooth. It's so tiny. It just, it's not a choking hazard or anything. So we use it just fine. Our family, that's going to give her that. The good bacteria in the gut to also help keep the intestines clear and the immune system working well to fight all those infections. Now, if your baby is having reoccurring, okay. So I was saying, if you have your little one gets reoccurring colds and infections, you can do this, give them up to three a day, let's say like at every meal or whenever you feed them solids while they're sick, just to replenish the good bacteria in the gut and to help get rid of the get the bad bacteria more in check. So here it is again, super tiny. And if you're afraid that they might choke on it, don't give it to them. You know, it's just a guaranteed way to know that they're getting the little probiotic for their intestinal health and digestive health and immune health. But you know, you saw how tiny it was. She took it no problem. But if you're not comfortable giving it to your child, then you know, that's fine too. So thanks for watching. That's a little bit about Slippery Elm. I'll show you how I do my grains. Like I said, this was just squash. You can mix it with anything, any type of food. And if the baby is really sick, you can give it to him just as a tea. And it does get really, really snotty looking. But it's very nourishing, calms the tummy, calms the intestines, and it's a way to give them nutrition and fill them up at the same time and help with any colicky why they're not feeling well. And of course, you can add in those powdered vitamins too. All right, you say bye, Mia. Say bye-bye. I'm still eating. Bye-bye.